Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Academy, and in this video we will learn how to measure the area of any land or any plot from the cadastral map using AutoCAD. I've opened the AutoCAD. I'm using AutoCAD 2020. You can use this with other versions of AutoCAD as well. And so here I'll just turn off the grids for right now. Okay. Cadastral maps are something like this, so they will also be called as the blueprints. These will be available at your local level offices, you know, the offices that are responsible for land measurements. You need to have documents of the land ownership, and once you give that document to them, they will give you the blueprint. So the real cadastral maps are somewhat like this with some extra information. So there will be the information given for the scales and where the location is. So I'm just using this image from the Google Images just to demonstrate how you do these things. Okay, so once you get the hard copy of this cadastral map, so there are cadastral map, you need to scan it using a proper scanner. So don't take a picture, because if you take the picture, the scale will be disturbed. That is why you need to scan it. The scanner will scan it in 1:1 ratio, and here somewhere the scale will be given in which scale this map has been prepared. Somewhere it's like 2500, sometimes it's like 5000. So I'll here use a arbitrary scale of 3000. So 1:3000 scale. So 1:3000 scale means that, so 1:30,000 scale means that, so 1:30,000, so let's take 30,000 as an example. So it means that, so if you got the piece of paper, okay, so the paper where the drawing or the map is made, and if you got some map, all right, so it means that 1 centimeter, so if you measure you know, a certain length from here to here, so 1 centimeter in paper, 1 centimeter in paper is equal to 30,000 centimeter at field. So if you got a map of any land or maybe of any house or any structure, so if you measure this from anywhere, so it will mean that 1 centimeter in that paper will be equal to 30,000 centimeter at field. So 1 centimeter, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So if we divide this by 100, so if I just cancel this, this is equal to 3000 meter, all right? And once you use your scale, and once you use your scale and you measure this length, and you found out that this is equal to, let's say 4 centimeter, it can be 4.2, 4.3, or maybe 5, then the site length, or you can say the field length, site length will be equal to 4 times 30,000. 1 cm is equal to 30,000, 4 cm is equal to 30 × 4,000. It will be equal to 12 10 and 3 0s, this much of centimeter, and you can convert it to the meter. So whatever, you know, unit you take for this portion, this value, the same unit you have to take for this value. If you say that in meter, if you take the unit in meter, right, then you have to take this in meter also, which means that 1:30,000 scale, it will mean that, so 1 meter in paper, so 1 meter in paper, 1 meter in paper is equal to 30,000 meter at field. So 4 cm will be equal to 0.04 meters, right? And if you just multiply this with this value, you will get the you know, same answer. All right, so these two units are consistent. So cadastral maps, the scale will be given, and you have to remember that scale. So now we'll go to the AutoCAD, and after that we'll go to the insert menu over here. And if you are using the earlier versions of AutoCAD from 2007 to 2013 or 14, then you will get the insert menu just like this. And there will, you will see insert raster image option, so you have to use that option. So here we will use attach option over here, so left click on it, Just find the folder where the image is located and we'll go to desktop. Okay, I just put the image somewhere here. Let me select the image. So I'll be using this image over here. So this is different than I showed you a little bit earlier. Okay, so that image I couldn't load, so I'm using this image over here. So I have taken this from the Google Earth just for the demonstration, and click on open. So after that you will see this window. Okay, so here you have to specify the scale, and if this is like checked on, you have to uncheck this, and you have to specify right over here. So scale, you have to use the scale that is given on your cadastral map. Normally on all the cadastral map the scale is given, and suppose that if I'll be using the scale of 1:30,000, and so rotation I don't want to give. Insertion point also I'll specify on the screen, and after that click on OK and just left click anywhere. Your image will be inserted. Okay, now what we have done is that delete this one. So our image was like 1:30,000 in scale, right? The paper was on that scale. What we do, we just scan it, and the scanner will do this paper in 1:1 scale, which means that our drawing, you know, that image file is also in this same scale, right? Because the scanner hasn't scaled it at all. And after that, what we do, we just inserted it to the AutoCAD, and we scaled it by 30,000. We scaled it by 30,000, which means that this paper, now we made it like this, increased it with the 30,000. So it means that now this image, the image that we just inserted using that scale, is in 1:1 scale, which means that whatever measurement we make in that image, I mean to say in this image, so these all measurements will be in 1:1 scale because we have scaled this drawing by 30,000. I hope you can understand this. Yeah, okay, so let me explain you again. So this is your land, right? So this is your land. So while drawing, so while making this cadastral map, so this was scaled down to like this paper with the scale of scaled down by 30,000, right? 30,000. Okay, so it was made small. So now what I have done, I have again scaled it to its original shape by scaling it with 30,000. So it was scaled down, it has been scaled up so that it is of actual length. Okay, so now all these measurements are in 1:1 scale, right? So what I will do now, we'll just draw a polygon around our land. Suppose that this is our land. Okay, so this plot number 215 is our land. This is a bit irregular. So now we will use a polyline option over here, and we'll draw a line that will just overlap these outlines. You can directly use the area command, but I don't recommend that. I don't prefer that. So left click on this polyline or hit PL command. Okay, and so just overlap this outline of your plot. So left click here, and after that left click here and come over here. Okay, right, so it needs to be pretty much accurate. And left click on this one, left click here, and finally left click here, and hit enter. After that hit the area command, type AA command, and hit enter. And after that just click on object, or if you are using the command, press O in your keyboard, and after that hit enter and select the object. So select this polyline, right click on it. Now it says that the area is this much. So you don't know what is the length, you don't know what is the unit of this length. So this area can be meter square, it can be feet square, it can be anything. So now what you need to do is that you need to change the units. So UN command and hit enter, and after that change the units to engineering. Okay, and we don't need the angle, and click on OK. Now again press AA command, hit AA command and click on enter, and after that press O and hit enter, and left click on this object. Now it says that the area is 14,250,254.8385 square inches, also the square feet, and it has also given the length. So this is how you find the area of your land. And as you know that I didn't have the scale of this image, that is why the land area might not be accurate, but in your case it must be accurate. All right guys, so hope this video was helpful. Thank you for watching and take care.